Good morning, peoples. Yeah, if you're doing this again, one core, 1 gig of RAM, and swap like that, this space just so you can see it. Yes, I'm running it in a VM, or else this would not be possible with modern technologies. Well, kind of could be, but, you know, the installation and stuff like that will just... It's just easy, okay? Don't get at me. It's not a scientific study, this is just, like, a little bit of fun. SSDs, okay? Running off SSDs, running on a Ryzen 5. People are asking for different desktops. We are trying this out. This is Trinity. This is basically came out in about the good old Windows XP area. So yeah, you will suspect that this desktop environment run okay, and it does. By the way, this is a bare-bone install. You can get like a full-blown install of the desktop, a basic and a minimum. I took the basics. And you can see here the desktop runs fine. The thing is, what if we start to do normal tasks? We'll just keep HTOP up here, I think. Oh, I haven't updated. This is a new install, by the way. A brand new install. So I haven't done an update yet either. Oh, let's skip all of this shit. Start browsing. So let's open up a terminal. And we can do sudo apt update. And I know this probably have an update manager and stuff like that. Oh, all packages is up to date. So it did update doing the install. So if we go on to face YouTube, it's already starting to be slow. What if we do Google? You know, it's starting to show. You can see how long it takes to load. Go on, we accept. So what if we do, let's open up Twitter, Instagram, Facebook. You can see it's really struggling here. And you can also see here it's starting to just max everything out. And even the desktop is starting to get a little bit junky. Allow all cookies. You can see it's really having a hard time. Well, not really a hard time, but it started to struggling. And I have 5 tabs open. So what is the idea with this? Why am I showing you this? And I clicked accept all. Come on, YouTube. Wake up. There you go. Thank you, buddy. Why am I showing you all of this? Well, can you run Linux on a really, 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 really low RAM and CPU system? Yes, you can. But what if you're doing normal tasks that normal users are doing? You can see here, like I'm clicking here. Come on. It's already starting to bug out. I guess most people, I'm just speculating here. I could be massively wrong. But I do guess that most people are going to watch YouTube videos. I don't think that's out of the realm of possibilities. It is kind of working. We are looking at the lo-fi girl here. Is that? Yeah, lo-fi girl. I clicked the button. And you can see it's already massively struggling here. So we have to remember this. Yes, you can get up and running. Yes, you can have a desktop environment. But when you start to do real-world shit, the real world kicks you in the balls and say, you know what? You're running a fucking really, really low powered system. And I'm going to punish you like the little bottom bitch you are. That's the sad reality of it. So don't believe everyone that says that, oh, you just need to install Arch with this fucking i3 and blah, 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 and everything would be dandy and well. It will be dandy and well if you are not going to open a browser or going to open up LibreOffice and do all of these kind of things. I don't even think I have LibreOffice installed in here. So let's see here. Programs. No, we don't even have LibreOffice installed. So I think they have something called a software. Yeah, install programs. Let's look at this. While we are also doing... let's look up Linux. And we go down here, we want LibreOffice. Install selected pack. I kind of like this program here, to be honest. Let's see, what do we... Oh, it's really, really hard to scroll down. Let's put you over there. Let's click next. This is actually kind of a little bit snappy in here. Let's do linux.org. install. What do we have here? You can see it's struggling again here now. Oop, come here. Is this a little bit better than, let's say, Windows 10 and GNOME and KDE or Plasma and stuff? Yeah, it's a little bit better. So instead you're getting like a, oh my god, I want to fucking run out and jump into a brick wall experience. It's like, oh my god, I need to get a fucking coffee. And it probably will be done when the coffee is done experience. So we're going from kind of crappy to a little bit crappy. And again, I'm not faulting Linux for this. This is just the world that we live in. This is not a Linux issue. This is not a Windows issue. This is just that people are overselling something to run on really, really low-powered hardware, where it's not the operating system's fault that, you know, the hardware is basically discarded. It's because the hardware is crap, okay? So all of the excuses and copiums in the world about how great Linux is and outdated hardware, that is true if you're not really doing real-world stuff. If I was only using this one here for light notepad editing, so I could be using this at work to SSH into a terminal or into a server and configure config files, that would be amazing. But if you're going to do everyday things that we are doing right here, it's struggling. The desktop environment is not really helping you here. It's really not. The only thing the desktop environment is doing is that instead of having a, like I said, massively crappy experience, you get a little bit of less crappy experience, but you're still getting a crappy experience. And I'm not having tabs open out of the ordinary here. Most people will have Twitter open, most people have something like Facebook open. Maybe the YouTube thing is a little bit like, okay, I'm poking a little bit too much here, but you get the idea. This is still just a one core system with 1 gig of RAM. No matter how many desktops you put on it or don't put on it or all of these kind of things, just see how slow it is to install LibreOffice. Is it running? Yeah, is it running better than, let's say, Ubuntu Mint that I had previously? Yeah. Is it running better than Windows 10? Yeah, but how much better is it running? Maybe 20% at best. But it's still not going to give the average person an enjoyable experience where they're like, oh my god, I can do everything we're doing in today's world on a 1-core, 1 gig of system because I'm using Linux. Laptop from 2010. Is it even searching? I think it is, yeah. I clicked finish. Now it's really fucking... Come on, there you go, buddy. So we can close this down. Oh, it's... I can't. It's fucking... Did I crash it? Did I crash it? No. You're still alive, baby. Come on. Come on, baby. Come on, baby. You can do this. Yeah, we got you. Yeah. I can click a button now. Come on, dude. Come on. At least Ubuntu didn't crash on me. At least Windows didn't crash on me. And I did more on Windows than I'm doing on this install here right now. And I did... Oh, there you go. And I did more on Cinnamon, Ubuntu Cinnamon, than I do right now. On Windows, I had control panels open, web browsers, and doing all... Go watch the video. And I can't spell, apparently. And the same within the Ubuntu Cinnamon desktop. I'm almost about to be inclined to say that Ubuntu Cinnamon is handling this workload better than this Q4OS is doing. Probably because Ubuntu is running a newer kernel that have more optimized memory management and so on and so on. Could probably be the reason why. So let's open up LibreOffice if it wants to do that. Oh, now I can't use anything. There you go. So if you're taking a high-end laptop from 2010, high mid to high-end laptop, you can probably be using it because it will probably have 4 cores, 8 cores, hyper-threading or something like that. Probably also have a couple of gigs, if not more, RAM. So you can definitely use, in quote, 10-year plus hardware in today's world. What I'm running right here, right now, is basically akin to like the 90s. I'm running a computer from the 90s, early 2000. That's basically what I'm running right now. And we all know that's obviously fucking bad. You know, that's all, like, nobody would in the right mind say, oh, let's get a fucking 486 and run modern Windows or Linux on it. You know, and this is a 64-bit system because I'm running in 64. If it was 32-bit, it would probably run a little bit better. And you can see here, this is just not enjoyable. I think I crashed it again, at least. Oh, no, it's still working. And again, I did more on Windows 10 on this system here. Go watch the video, Windows versus Linux on 1 core, 1 gig of RAM. I have a link to it down in the description. I was doing way more than I was doing here. And I know, oh, why are you using LibreOffice and not Happy Word? Or you should be doing, you know, using Nano. And I am looking at this from an average user. What is the majority of users going to do? So yes, could you live as a fucking brave and strong and beautiful Linux user in the terminal to save resource and revive old computers? Yes, you can. That's why you're brave, beautiful, and strong. The rest of us that are not brave, that are not strong, that are ugly as balls, we are going to do this thing right here. And again, I'm not really doing anything massively tasking here. Again, I did way more on the Windows. Windows had fucking updates running in the background, and it was still running. It was still running. And I could still use it way more than I can use this system right here, right now. Cinnamon on Ubuntu, latest release of Ubuntu, was doing more than this system is doing here right now. I didn't have LibreOffice open, but I was tasking it as well. And it was more responsible than this one is here right now. I cannot use this right now. So yeah, I hope I made my point. It's not that you can't get Windows installed on older hardware. You can't get Linux installed on older hardware. It's that when the second you start to do real world work, you are getting into issues. No, this is not Linux issue. This is not a Windows issue. This is the issue. This here. The hardware. This is the issue. It's not Linux. It's not Windows. It's just a matter of how small of a percent is less crappy is it going to get. Because the hardware is the issue. Where's my mouse? I think I actually crashed the system. Yeah, Windows actually did not crash. Oh, no, there it is. I actually think I crashed the system. I can't use it. I crashed the system. This has now become unresponsible. I'm maxing out the PEG file or swap file. I'm maxing out the RAM. We are creating the CPU at the crash of the program. Was only 42%. So what can we conclude out of this? Windows is slow. Slower than Linux when you're not doing anything other than just messing around with the, you know, a file manager and stuff like that. But when you're tasking your system, when you're really, oh, now I can use my mouse again. When you're really using your system in real life for real life stuff, Windows is even on par with Linux when you're doing real life stuff, or a little bit better. Is it so much better that you should now install Windows on all your old hardware? Fuck no. It's just like I said, do you want to suck 100% or do you want to suck 95%? It's both of them are sucking. Now I have to restart this fucking VM, hard restart this VM. See you all later. Bye bye.